I grew up in a really diverse family. My grandparents from Puerto Rico actually grew up Santeria, and when they came to America, became a part of the Episcopal Church because, you know, they learned English and it felt comfortable for them. And my mother's Jewish, and her family is from Russia and speaks Yiddish, and, you know. So I was always surrounded by religion and very interested in it, and also felt kind of pulled in different ways. But I was very lucky to grow up in this really loving, welcoming Episcopal church, and they had a lot of opportunities for kids. So, you know, it's hard to get kids to go to church and really be into it sometimes, but they kept giving me things to do. And when you're, you know, I have an older brother who's bigger than me, and I was the little one, and it was nice to be given all these opportunities to learn and try leadership out when you're young, and to have older people, you know, people you look up to, say, I trust you, you know, try this out, see how it fits. So when I started thinking about what I wanted to do, I was listing all these qualities. I was like, I want to work with people, I want to help others, outreach is very important to me, I want something that's grounded in spirituality and sharing, and I kept finding myself coming back to this idea of the Eucharist, and I was like, if that's what I want to center my life around, well, there's a job right there, you know. And somebody actually pointed it out to me. One of my priests said, you know, you're kind of describing being a priest. And I said, you're joking. But here I am. And for me, I was trying to reconcile my faith with the world, and I kept trying to think, how can I bring these elements in, you know, into church, into that faith, into the spirit? And I realized that it's not bringing it in, it's pushing out and letting my idea of faith and community expand. And Christ's body is not inside four walls, it's everywhere. And it can be difficult because for instance, right now I'm working at a community center, and a lot of people come by and they've been really scarred by what has happened to them in the church. They've lived hard lives, they've had difficult experiences. People have told them that God's love wasn't big enough for them. And so I think for me, my ministry would definitely be to sort of right that wrong and say, no way, like, God's love is big enough for everybody, whether or not you know it, whether or not you can believe it. A very wise priest once said to me, after the death of someone close to me, I went for some counseling, and he said, you know what, there is no heaven and no hell, there's only being far away or absent from God's love, and that's a choice. And for me, I think my ministry would be just to sort of try and teach people in different ways, maybe as a parish priest, maybe not, maybe volunteering, working at a shelter, that God's love is big enough for them. I've wanted, as a religion major, to study faiths outside of my own and to see different ways of experiencing life and experiencing faith. And the Bhagavad Gita is an amazing way to do that. It's an ancient Hindu text. It's Krishna, the god Krishna, speaking to Arjuna before a battle. And Krishna describes his presence. He says, he who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me will not be lost to me, and I will not be lost to him. And you could just as easily put, you know, credit Jesus. You know, that is such a wonderful statement of faith, that if you can really see God everywhere and see also everything through him, then first you won't lose sight of him, and he also will not lose sight of you.